Tonight, over 100,000 firecrackers, 21 floats, 16 bands, dragons galore, hundreds of kung fu and lion dancers, and over 300,000 spectators.
They're all here to celebrate the Year of the Rooster. It's the San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
Union Square, a celebration for the Year of the Rooster, the San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
It's an exciting evening here in San Francisco as tens of thousands of people get ready to welcome the Year of the Rooster.
And as the year struts and crows its way in, it promises to be a year of prosperity and good luck. Hi, I'm Cynthia Gao.
And I'm Steve McPartlin, and together we will bring you and take a look at the largest festival of its kind outside of Asia. And Cynthia, welcome home.
Thank you very much. I'm so glad to be back in my hometown. I've been in Dallas, Texas for a while.
Yes, Cynthia is currently working as an anchorwoman for the CBS affiliate in Dallas. And Cynthia, I've been doing a lot of my homework since we did this last year, and I want to give this to you. I understand this is a Lycee envelope, and that brings you good luck.
Well, Steve, how sweet of you, but I have a very business-like question to ask you.
Yes, what is it?
Are you married?
No.
Well, that's important because...
Who would marry me? That's a big thing there. No.
That's doubtful.
That's not going to happen.
The reason why is Lycee envelopes go from married people to single people, and although I do appreciate your kind things, like, my goodness, this is funny money.
It's the thought that counts, Cynthia. Okay, let's continue on. The parade is just about ready to get underway. So let's take a look down on the streets of San Francisco to see just what the Year of Rooster has in store for us this evening. And what we're looking at now are some very colorful flags. And they are preceding what is, or what will be rather, the ceremonial giant gong of Chinatown. And this parade officially starts when that gong is, when it's gonged, actually. Kind of odd. And then you can see the gong now, and this is the ceremonial gong heralding the opening of tonight's festivities.
And there it goes. This huge brass noisemaker is being wheeled along by volunteers from the San Francisco Chinese Chamber of Commerce. Now, the Chinese hosts this parade, but the 3 weeks of celebration that lead up to tonight's celebration of lion dancers, dragons, and martial artists has been a long-awaited event. And we might mention that according to the Chinese calendar, this year will be number 4691.
And now the Tat Wong Kung Fu Academy, sponsored tonight by the San Francisco Chronicle. Tat Wong is one of the largest groups in the parade tonight, and they're being led by a spirited group of lion dancers, which you'll be able to see in just a few moments. They're right behind the track there, and we'll be seeing lots of lion dancing tonight, so you won't be confused. Now, here's a tip to tell the difference between a dragon and a lion. Lion dances are performed by only two people, while dragons normally require 10 or more people for a performance.
Now, there are about 100 participants here from Tat Wong, and they range in age from 5 to 55.
Oh, my goodness.
A large range there.
And you can see the lion dancers down there, right, on the left of your screen, and there's some of the youngsters from the Tat Wong Kung Fu Academy. The younger students are performing Kung Fu hand routines, and they'll be followed by another group. There you see them working with an ancient Kung Fu weapon, the three-section staff.
Well, the sectional staff can be very dangerous, and you have to be very careful when you're practicing with it. And the Tat Wong Academy has one of the largest children's kung fu programs in the country.
And the director of the academy is Tat Mao Wang, who has been inducted into the Martial Arts Hall of Fame as a superb kung fu instructor. And Master Tat Mao Wang, he's doing a double sword versus a spear demonstration, and that is the master in the white tunic. I want to point that out to you. Kind of looks dangerous to me,
Cynthia. Absolutely, I'm glad we're up here. Now, we see no weapons here. It's actually black belt instructors. They're demonstrating finding hand forms.
And that is Susan Farrar, one of the few female black belt instructors in Northern California. It's fun to see these youngsters participate.
They are so enthusiastic. Look
at that. Also fun to see these youngsters from all sorts of ethnic diversity participating in the Chinese
New Year Parade.
Absolutely,
and that's the spirit of San Francisco for you right there.
And as we said, this is still the Tatwan Kung Fu Academy, and it is one of the largest. The academy itself has over 500 members and is the largest Kung Fu Academy in North America. And there's one of the lions. You'll be seeing lots and lots of these cute little fellas there. I think he just gave our cameraman a real big lick. Don't you think so?
He's in love.
And what we're seeing now is the three-section staff.
And here they are, the traditional fighting staffs.
And as you can see, you have to be very agile to perform these routines. And you can hear in the background the sound of firecrackers. You might as well get used to that, because you'll probably be hearing that all evening long in the background. Firecrackers play a big role in the Chinese New Year Parade. And
they scare away evil spirits.
They do. And, mm-hmm. and we will scare away every evil spirit within a two-mile radius at the end of this parade when about 60,000 of them go off there.
From the University of California at Berkeley, the parade's first dragon.
And it's being carried by a bunch of bears. Cal Bears, of course, sponsored by the San Francisco Chronicle. There are 30 UC students from a variety of Asian clubs on Berkeley's campus toting this brilliantly colored dragon.
Mayor Feinstein's husband is in this dragon we're being told.
That's him right there,
there
as a matter of fact.
Former mayor, that is.
It's current Senator Feinstein, of course, is how we should refer to her. And she will be joining the parade in just a few moments, actually, because she is the honorary Grand Marshal. Look at this.
That is spectacular.
I've never seen an electric dragon before in my entire life.
Besides Puff.
That is really terrific. Yes.
Okay, we've got the red ball there. It's on top of the pole just ahead of the dragon. Can be brought into view here, and that's kind of a flaming pearl. It's kind of like a lure for the dragon to follow. And if he captures the pearl, it'll give him a great amount of energy. It's right there. There we see it.
Now, Cynthia, the Chinese dragon is kind of a patchwork creature created from the parts of many animals. The mythological dragon has the eyes of a rabbit, mouth of a camel, ears of a cow, whiskers of a catfish, scales of a carp, paws of a tiger, and talons of an eagle. And
all
here we
right.
go.
And playing traditional American and Chinese marching tunes, the Hipwo School Drum and Bell Corps. Now, the Hipwo School was founded in 1924 and teaches the Cantonese dialect of southern China.
And some of the Hipwo performers are wearing red uniforms. Red symbolizes good luck, and others are wearing white and gold to symbolize fortune.
And that's it. The key ingredient, good luck and good fortune, traditional wishes for the new year.
And as we mentioned, ladies and gentlemen, the newly elected senator from the state of California, Dianne Feinstein, is the Grand Marshal of the 1993 San Francisco Chronicle Chinese Parade.
Dianne, how's she doing down there?
Well, she's doing quite well. Joining me is Senator Dianne Feinstein, and welcome home.
Thank you very much. Good to be home.
I'm sure it is. You've been to many of these Chinese New Year's Day parades. It's a very important part of the San Francisco tradition.
It's a very important tradition. I think it's probably the largest parade the city has outside of a Super Bowl parade. And the crowds are on both sides of all of the streets. And it's a special year. So I hope it harkens well for all of us.
Take good care of you and have a wonderful...
Thank you so much.
Back to you in the booth.
Thanks, Dianne.
And next up, the high-spirited and high-stepping members of the UC Davis Cal Aggie Marching Band. Their first appearance in the Chinese New Year Parade is sponsored by The Chronicle.
Now, this is one of the very few university bands in the country run entirely by students. There's no class credit or pay for any of these Aggie band members.
And tonight, they're under the direction of Park Allen, and their drum major is Catherine Dewey. Let's give them a listen. We'll be right back.
Now a little more mechanized mode of transport, a pair of San Francisco Chronicle newspaper delivery trucks.
Now every year the Chronicle and Parade magazines select two paper carriers to go on an all-expenses-paid trip to Europe. And this year we'd like to congratulate Laura Zai and Courtney Sid, who'll be leaving for England in April. All right, they're the lucky ones.
And a cock-a-doodle-doo, it's a San Francisco Chronicle float.
And in honor of the new year of the rooster, the float features a giant rooster waking up with the San Francisco Chronicle, the Bay Area's morning newspaper.
Now they're throwing fortune cookies at the crowd, and there goes one now. Also on this float, we're seeing Mr. Gus Lee. He's the author of China Boy, and his family is along there on the float with him. Now, he wrote a story about growing up Chinese-American in San Francisco's Tenderloin District, a very nice book.
And
it's the mayor of San Francisco. I'm sorry, Steve.
That's my fault. Go right ahead.
The Honorable Frank Jordan. And Channel 2's Diane Dwyler is down on the parade route. Diane, how is he doing tonight?
Well, I think he's doing quite well. Are you having a nice time here tonight?
Oh, yes. The weather has really been showing tremendously tonight, the best I've seen in many, many years. And I've never seen this big a crowd. It's a tremendous amount of enthusiasm, a lot of great spirit.
Any message for all the people of your city?
Well, I think the biggest message is this diversity that we see here tonight. Fabulous. It's tremendous. The year of the rooster, which is the Chinese lunar year, 4691. What it shows is the diversity is here, but it's those of us who are living here as well as those who come from all over the world to see this magnificent parade.
Have a happy new year to you too.
Thank you very much.
Back to you in the booth.
All right, thanks, Diane. Well, everybody looks remarkably dry tonight, don't you think?
Oh, very dry tonight. Now coming up from Irvine, California, this is the University High School Marching Band.
Their sensational drum major was selected to lead a 600-piece band at the grand opening of Euro Disney in France last year.
Groups from all over California come to perform in this parade every year, and the 70 musicians from University High School traveled over 400 miles from Orange County to be with us this evening. Terrific. Now coming up at the 1993 San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade, world champion women karate experts practice their martial arts, and they won't be pulling any punches.
And speaking of punches, I hear that Bart Simpson is somewhere along the parade route terrorizing innocent bystanders.
Well, maybe Homer will be able to keep him intact there. Nah.
We'll be right back. Parade coverage. Stay with us.
The San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade is sponsored in part by Southwest Airlines. It's just plain smart. Cold filtered Miller Genuine Draft, your Northern California Toyota dealer, and the San Francisco Chronicle.
Since the Chronicle first hit the streets of San Francisco in 1865, we haven't missed a day. Whether the news was bad or whether the news was good, the Chronicle has delivered it now for 46,780 mornings, even when nature shook the city down. As a young new president takes office and Chinese New Year 4691 begins, we invite you to join in a grand old tradition and wake up to the Chronicle every morning.
Only the finest tools in the hands of skilled, dedicated craftsmen can produce a masterpiece. Today's China Airlines combines professionalism with the personal touch to meet your every need on the ground and in the air. The kind of service that, in itself, is a work of art. China Airlines, we treasure each encounter.
It's a big place, America. But we've all gotten pretty good at getting around in it. So when you're the Bank of America, you put yourself in the right spot so you can be there when people arrive. Banking on America. Bank of America.
The reviews are in, and this new Toyota is a winner. Automobile Magazine calls it a global success. Motor Trend calls it a car with definite family influences from Camry and Lexus. Detroit Free Press calls it the benchmark. We call it Corolla. Presenting the all-new Toyota Corolla. Discover why, after 25 years, it's still impressing all the right people.
It's the year of the rooster and the San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
And welcome back. I'm Steve McPartland along with Cynthia Gao.
And the excitement is just building up here at the 1993 San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade, ushering in the Year of the Rooster.
And later on, we'll get to see the beautiful winner of the Miss Chinatown USA pageant and a new addition to the parade this year, a helium-filled dragon balloon. All that is on its way, but right now, let's check back in and see what's going on.
Oh, my goodness.
I told you to get used to fireworks, didn't I?
Wow, we're hearkening in the new year here in fine style. This is the San Francisco Chinatown Lion Dance Association, sponsored by Sprint.
There's not an evil spirit within blocks of here now. These folks get together once a week all year long to practice lion dancing here in Chinatown. They offer free classes for anyone interested in learning the complex moves and traditions involved in lion dancing.
Now, they go through a very detailed ceremony before dancing with these lions. First, they bless the eyes so the lion can see, and then they bless the ears so it can hear, and then finally the mouth so it can speak. Now, when they're finished blessing the lion, of course, it's thought to be taking on a life of its own.
Now, this group is very active with community-related performances, fundraisers, street fairs, and some of the members of this group are as young as 3 years old. And now riding into view, California's Secretary of State, March Fong Yu.
Ms. Yu is the highest-ranking Asian American in California's state government, and she's been in office since 1974.
And she was a very big supporter of President Bill Clinton's while he was running. And in the next convertible, carrying Mr. Sidney Chan, the president of the San Francisco Chinese Chamber of Commerce.
San Francisco's Chinese Chamber of Commerce dated its beginning as far back as 1952.
A little correction. That's not Sidney Chan. This is Bill Wong, and he's the president of the Chinese Consolidated Benevolent Association. And the Benevolent Association is a group made up of various Chinatown family associations.
And for many years, has served as an unofficial government body for San Francisco's Chinese community, kind of like a city hall for Asians and Americans from China.
And coming into view now, the float from China Airlines, and its theme is Children of the World.
And it's a very modern float they're riding on. It's shaped like a giant jet airplane that carries a revolving globe. And it symbolizes the shrinking distances between people and cultures in this age of jet travel and instant communications.
And look at those adorable children on top of the China Airlines float. Of course, you can recognize Miss Liberty there right on top of the float, the Statue of Liberty. And the song that is being played in the background, just in case you can't make it out, is We Are the World. Jeez, it makes me want to sing the song. Of course, everyone would turn off their television sets if I did that, so I won't sing.
Okay. Now, here's another group of out-of-towners coming up after this float. And they're all the way from Washington State, the Pasco High School Bulldogs marching band, and they're presented by the Bank of America.
And the Bulldogs are being led by drum majors Jennifer Connolly and Tammy Williams. The band is looking very sharp in those Aussie-style cowboy hats. There are 80 performers in the Bulldogs and another 20 in the auxiliary.
Mm-hmm.
past us now, a motorized cable car from Home Savings of America.
Now, Cynthia, that's the smart way to ride through this parade.
Absolutely. Now, these are employees from all 8 Home Savings of America branches riding the cable car. And as we all know, the San Francisco's real cable cars are U.S. National Historical Landmarks on wheels.
Okay, this was supposed to be afloat, but it broke down. And they're from the Chinese Community Smoke-Free Project, sponsored by the Chinese Community Health Plan and the Chinese Community Healthcare Association.
And their whole group is to get to stop smoking message across to kids.
Faster. We have to go faster.
And when we return, one of the parade's most dangerous stunts, a gung fu expert from San Jose will show us how to steal the dragon's pearl by walking on top of a 4-foot-tall rubber ball.
Ooh, I can't wait to see that. And that and more as the San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade continues. Please stay with us.
Filtered Miller Genuine Draft. The world's a very cool place.
On Southwest Airlines, friends fly free for business too. For example, if Dunn buys a ticket, Bradstreet flies free. Buy one round-trip ticket at Southwest Airlines' regular low unrestricted fare, and your friend flies with you free. So if Bausch buys a ticket, Lom flies free. Or if Ben buys a ticket, Jerry flies free. Friends fly free for business. Only on Southwest Airlines. Just plain smart.
Acupuncture has been proven to be an effective treatment for aches and pains. But did you know that it's a way to stop smoking also?
Move your checking account to Wells Fargo for a better brand of service, like 5-Minute Max. Wells Fargo guarantees you'll get to a teller in less than 5 minutes, even at high noon on payday. 5-Minute Max, guaranteed. Why not move all your accounts to Wells Fargo today?
Run out time!
The change of scene will do you good. Wells Fargo Bank, a better brand of service.
Volvo just figured out how to lower the defense budget without threatening national security. Call for the dealer nearest you. While the new administration may offer Americans a new lease on life, we can definitely offer you a new lease on a Volvo. Call for the dealer nearest you.
The San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade continues with your hosts, Steve McPartland and Cynthia Gao.
And welcome back to the San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade. Let's get right back into the action. And here's a great group of gung fu fighters, the lion dancers and martial arts experts from the East West Gung Fu Karate School in Santa Clara.
Now here's that ball walker we were telling you about.
Yes, and the ball is called the Dragon's Pearl, and it's supposed to be what attracts the dragon and what the dragon follows around.
When you walk the ball, it's called stealing the Dragon's Pearl, and it's very, very dangerous.
In fact, the Gung Fu master who was supposed to be walking the ball in the parade tonight fell and broke his arm last month while demonstrating this. Our best wishes go out to him. He's healing nicely, we understand, and we sure hope our ball walker tonight has a safe trip throughout the parade.
That's a big 2 miles there, and there he is.
It certainly is.
A very brave man.
And he's a ham as well. He's smiling and waving right to the camera as he's walking on the ball. I couldn't do that. That's a real neat trick.
Oh,
And let's go down to the parade route and check in with Diane Dwyer, who's found a couple of familiar faces from the original 10 o'clock news.
I think very familiar faces. Elaine Corral, Dennis Richmond, and Dennis's daughter, Amber. How are you all doing?
It's great. It's not raining this year. The first time that we can remember. Beautiful.
It's not raining. It's not cold. I got my baby with me. It's great out here.
Now, listen, you guys have been through a lot of these. What's the favorite part of the parade to you two?
When the float doesn't run into the crowd.
That's a good thing. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful time, Dennis.
And all the people. There's so many people out here, and they're all waving, saying they all watch Channel 2. That's the best part.
That is. They're so nice out here. Everyone along the route is waving, and they're just wonderful. So that's the fun part.
Have a wonderful time. Thanks for stopping in. Back to you, Steve and Cynthia.
Thanks, Diane. Our next group tonight is the Mandarins Drum and Bugle Corps, sponsored by the Home Savings of America. The Mandarins are from the Sacramento area and are the only all-Asian nationally competitive drum and bugle corps in the United States.
And are they ever competitive? They're the current world champions among Division III Drum and Bugle Corps.
And they'll be taking their distinctive pink and black uniforms on the road. They're going to defend their title at the World Championships in where else? Jackson, Mississippi.
What's in store for us in the year of the rooster? According to Chinese legend, the rooster will bring bright and happy days, but be careful because the rooster is prone to make simple things complicated as he crows his way through our lives. Now, I think you might not want to bet on any long shots in the upcoming 12 months.
Well, many people think the phrase Gung Hei Fat Choi means Happy New Year, but it's actually a term to wish someone prosperity for the new year.
Well, technically that's what it means.
Mm-hmm.
And how would you say it? No, why am I asking? You don't know what that means. Okay.
And roaring up to us now, the lion dancers from the Jingyi Lion Dance Troupe. We're here tonight with six lion dancing teams performing the stylized moves of traditional southern Chinese lion dancing.
Now, Cynthia, remember I told you I've been doing my homework this year, and I found out that one of the reasons that Chinese lions look so colorful is because lions aren't native to China. So when lion dancing began some 2,000 years ago, people had to rely on descriptions from travelers to such faraway lands as India to create the costumes.
And this is Eric Liu. He's 6 years old, and he's been in the New Year's parade for the past 4 years. And he carries the distinction of being one of the youngest people in the parade.
And I would certainly think probably one of the youngest lion dancers in
Absolutely.
The country, or maybe even the world.
Anchored down there. All right. There he goes.
He's anchored down by the fellow holding him by his ankles right there.
We Speak Your Language is a theme of AT&T's Float. Now, it features a pair of very important characters from Chinese mythology, the dragon and the phoenix.
And they always appear together during times of peace and prosperity, so it's very good luck to have them both together here tonight.
That's right, Steve. And they're thought of as a very romantic couple. Together, they symbolize double happiness, which is why the dragon and the phoenix are a big feature in traditional Chinese weddings.
And I think as we look at all of the participants in the parade, you can see that the Chinese New Year parade is very familiar, very family event for this young people and old people all celebrating this time of year together.
Very much so. Now, we're seeing three cable cars that are carrying some very happy kids. They're winners of the Pier 39 Kite Festival, and each one of them designed an award-winning kite using a Chinese theme. The Kite Festival is just part of the 3 weeks of celebration around San Francisco as part of the Chinese New Year celebration.
And we'll be back with all the excitement of the 1993 San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
Including a salute to one of China's most popular forms of entertainment, opera.
And later, the 160-foot-long Gum Lung Dragon with 60,000 firecrackers.
We'll be right back.
Hold your ears.
attraction, they found it deep in the heart of Texas. Cops moves to Fort Worth. All new episodes, all new location. Then, you've seen daredevils perform incredible stunts, but what happens when something goes wrong? Tonight, when their chute fails to open, these skydivers' only chance for rescue is the cameraman. And see what happens when a breathtaking movie stunt takes an unexpected turn.
Code 3, tonight at 9 on Channel 2.
Ciao, molto bene. Mama Burger King will be so happy.
I love this place.
Yes. Take it from me, Danny Paisan. Have you tried the new Italian sausage sandwich here? It's Italian sausage, flame broiled. It comes with either mozzarella or marinara sauce or peppers and onions. This is for you. You try it. This is the Italian experience. I'm not saying this sandwich is great, but I saw Mona Lisa smiling. It's like a slice of Italy. It's your way, right away.
I love this place.
Finding a credit card you can expect more from is a simple process of elimination. First, blow up all the cards with the highest rates. Then the ones that don't offer fixed or variable rate options, worldwide acceptance, and 24-hour customer service. And what about price assurance? Satisfaction guaranteed, purchase protection, and extended warranties at no extra charge. So, what's left? Chemical Bank Visa. If you have one, use it. If not, call 1-800-342-9900 to apply.
This is the Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme Special Edition. It's got a V6, 4-speed automatic, air, cruise control, and other neat stuff. It's also $4,000 less than a Honda Accord, $4,100 less than a Toyota Camry, and more than $5,000 less than that Nissan Maxima. The Cutlass Supreme Special Edition. It's your choice.
The San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade continues and is sponsored in part by Chemical Bank Visa and MasterCard.
And a big welcome back. I'm Cynthia Gao.
And I'm Steve McPartland.
And you're watching the biggest celebration of its kind outside of Asia, the 1993 San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
And this great group of kids of the Rooster had it vanguard for San Francisco's Sherman Elementary School, sponsored by Sherman Clay Pianos. The Sherman School is celebrating its 101st anniversary this year. The school has won first place for the last 2 years in the Best Community Float category.
And as you can see there, their float has the traditional Chinese dragon and phoenix theme.
You look at the faces, and they're so cute, and they look like they're having so much fun, except for that fellow on the left there. He looks like he'd rather be watching a ball game. And now it's time for another trip down to the parade route. Diane Dwyer's down there. Hey, who are those people? I don't know them.
These guys just fell out of the car almost anyway. How you guys doing?
Okay, as long as they go slow, we're okay. Otherwise, it's dangerous.
We're having a great time here, Diane.
Laura, Ross, Frank, I think there's somebody missing here.
You know, we had to go to traffic court yesterday. We haven't seen him since.
Tell him we went this way, okay? We expect him to jog right up anytime. I don't know.
Let me ask you this. What's the best part of the parade so far?
For me, it's all the children. People bring their children, and it's just great. All these families are lined up here and having a great night together. That's really nice to see.
I'd really have to second that, seeing all these people out here and the families having a good time and no rain. Yeah. It really is a nice, warm night, and there's no rain, and we're having a lot of fun.
It is a beautiful evening. Have a great time, you two. Back to you, Steve and Cynthia.
Thanks, Diane.
And I've got to tell you something. They're very fun to work with, too. Oh, my
there
goodness.
They go.
Who's driving that vehicle
really,
there?
Really, who's driving there?
Hey, don't hurt my co-hosts there, please.
And marching into our picture right now is a black and gold regiment from Wilcox High School in Santa Clara, sponsored by the Pacific Bell Smart Yellow Pages. This is a relatively new marching band. They started in 1990, and they've won 27 awards in the past 2 years. And their sounds have performed in the 1991 Chinese New Year Parade. This year they're planning on a 4-day tour of Vancouver, British Columbia. Good luck to them.
Mm-hmm.
You know what, Cynthia? I know something about Wilcox High School.
What's that?
One of their graduates is the very famous former third baseman, former All-Star, former American League batting champ for the Oakland A's. Barney Lansford went to school at Wilcox High.
Very good.
How about
he probably started in the band.
Anytime I get to show off my intelligence, I'll do it. Not that we would call
I'm impressed.
Intelligence at all. Luciano Pavarotti, move over. Our next float is a tribute to the Chinese opera sponsored by the Bank of America. And those giant masks represent very famous figures from the world of Chinese opera.
Now, opera Chinese style can be a lot different from Western opera. It's very exciting, and it's, of course, been very popular and important in Chinese culture. During California's gold rush, as many as four different opera troupes were supported by the Chinese community here in San Francisco. And besides playing in the city, the opera companies toured the gold mining camps in California's motherlode country. Beautiful float.
I don't think you expect that those gold miners had so much culture that they would listen to opera.
That's right.
And you'll recognize our next parade guest from the hundreds of motion pictures and TV shows he's appeared in. Let's see some of his work.
James Hong, the actor you were just watching. James, any message for all the people here today?
Well, happy year of the rooster. And this is especially a good year for women because they can henpeck their husband and boyfriends all year long.
I like that. I'll use that. Let me ask you this. You've promoted Asian Americans in your field, in the movie-making field. How has it gone so far?
Unfortunately, it hasn't progressed as much as we would like it to. As you see, I'm still playing villains and, you know.
But you're very successful.
Well, I can do other good parts, too, you know, good guys.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, fair enough. We look forward to that, James. Happy 4,609.
Same to you, and I'm sure my friend and all here would like to wish you the same thing, Harry Mock. And so.
Happy New Year to all of you, and Happy New Year to you.
He's a scary character in those movies, and that's certainly scary news he gave us guys about being henpecked, didn't it?
Well, when we return, we'll have finding out what would happen to scouts huffing and puffing and blowing up a gigantic balloon dragon.
And we'll get to see some traditional Chinese fan dancing. All this when the parade honoring the Year of the Rooster continues from San Francisco.
Be right there.
When you opened the Chen Yipun Ballet School 3 years ago, did you use the Pacific Bell Smart Yellow Pages?
Yes, we started with the Yellow Pages right away. We get the best response. When the parents call us, we ask them where did they hear about our school, and they say they look through the Yellow Pages.
We say if it's not in the Pacific Bell Smart Yellow Pages, maybe it doesn't exist. Your ad says sprung floor. What is that?
The resilience in the floor is very important for the muscles. And
let me try this and see what happens here. Oh, yeah, I think. You think I have potential? What do you think?
You can sign up for an audition.
Oh,
if
really?
You like.
Yeah, right. Don't call us. We'll call you. You've never before.
At a New Year's banquet, it's common to serve chicken and fish with head and feet or fins attached. And so the year begins in the spirit of wholeness.
I work hard for my money.
It goes way too fast.
So I look for good deals. Things that'll last.
We're buying a Toyota.
It's a great car for the family. Now comes the hard part. Corolla,
Tercel,
or Camry. They're the family cars by Toyota.
T-O-Y-O-T-A. Get a great deal on a Corolla, Tercel, or Camry now at your Northern California Toyota dealer.
Located on Union Square since 1904, the St. Francis is the official hotel of the Chinese New Year Parade. Discover why St. Francis means San Francisco.
That's why he told me he wanted to lick my legs.
Love connection.
Baby, I'll make love to you as long as you keep those glasses on.
Oh.
Love connection.
I couldn't stop staring at her chest. I mean.
Yeah.
Love connection. Romance doesn't get any hotter than this.
Love connection. Weeknights at 7:30 on Channel 2. The San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade continues with your hosts, Steve McPartland and Cynthia Gao.
And welcome back, just in time to catch the double drummers of the Zhongnai Lion Dance Troupe and a young lady on a unicycle.
There she is, balancing some dishes on her head. Well, the Zhongnai is a nonprofit community group that's been active in Chinatown for 26 years. They've been sponsored tonight by the Home Savings of America Bank. They have about 30 performers in the parade this evening. Maybe 31.
Well, I got to tell you, that's some nifty trick there. It's difficult enough to ride a unicycle without having balls on your head, no doubt.
Can you imagine 2 miles on this parade route?
Here's a magical display, a 120-foot-long balloon dragon. 4 San Francisco scouting groups are guiding this dragon through tonight's parade. The Boy Scouts of Troop 3 from San Francisco's Richmond District, the Cub Scouts from PAC 3 in the Noe Valley neighborhood, and the Girl Scouts from Troops number 3194 and 3195 out near the Pacific Ocean in the Sunset District.
Steve, there are 2,000 balloons making up the body of that dragon, and the Scouts have been working for the past 2 weekends to blow them all up.
It's a lot of air in there.
Really? So what do you do with 2,000 balloons in the shape of a dragon when the parade is over? They tell us, of course, it's too big to store, so the Scouts' dragon will be on display at the Chinese Trade Center all next week.
That's a good use for it. I think they should let it go and let it float maybe, you know, somewhere in Milwaukee, some guy having a beer somewhere.
A little UFO action, right?
We'll see this dragon come down on his lawn and just scare the heck out of the poor fellow. I think that would be fun. And you know, the Boy Scouts from Troop 3 bear the distinction of being the first all Chinese-American scout troop in the country. They were founded way back in 1914.
And I hope they're anchored by a lot of people there. That balloon looks like that dragon's about to...
What a wonderful effort that must have been to be... What a wonderful effort it has been, rather, to put that dragon together for those scouts. I think they get merit badges in dragon building now.
A little balloon making
there. Or at least in ballooning.
Absolutely.
And now it's serpentining its way through the streets following a ball, as you can see right there, of balloons.
These yellow and green satin costumes belong to the Spring Valley Elementary School Marching Unit.
Now, they're not just marches, Cynthia. There are also some traditional Chinese band dancers with this group. Spring Valley Elementary is celebrating its 141st birthday this year. It is the oldest public school in California. And there you see some of the lovely young fan dancers.
Well, it's so nice it didn't rain this year. Now they can see their whole costumes, the whole parade. They love to read, the signs say.
And here comes a float with a definite barnyard attitude.
That's right. In honor of the Year of the Rooster, the Commodore Stockton Elementary School has gone all out. Their float is sponsored by PG&E, and its theme is Energizing Young Minds is Something to Crow About.
Now, education has always been important in the Chinese culture. Where there were competitive exams for government jobs 1,000 years before the West discovered civil service.
Oh, look at them. They're just like little chicks. And they're about to hatch.
You know, I got to let everybody know that as you see many of these floats and bands for the first time, we are seeing them for the first time as well. And we find it just as cute and just as adorable as you're finding it at home, no doubt.
And now a double shot of talent, sports and weather. KTVU's own Pat McCormick and Mark Abanez And how are these people enjoying tonight, being chauffeured through tonight's parade, Diane?
Well, they're certainly having a wonderful time. It looks like, I don't even know if they've noticed me yet. Oh, I think Pat has. Pat, exactly. What happened to the good luck ring?
Well, it'll be here after midnight, Diane.
That's the perfect timing. Mark, over here. How you doing?
Hey, I'm okay. I'm just happy to be riding with the weatherman who told me it definitely would not rain. So I'm smart. I'm riding with the right guy.
It's a first, just about.
And I got to say hello to my two oldest friends, Lolo and Toby. Thank you very much. All right. Gung Hei Fat Choi.
Back to you.
Thank you. Hey, I'm okay. That Mark Abanius is a poet and you don't know it. Okay, this next group has been playing in the annual Chinese New Year's Parade since back in the 70s. It's the San Francisco Lesbian and Gay Freedom Marching Band, and this year marks the 15th anniversary of this group of performers.
They just returned from Washington, D.C., where they were one of the bands along President Clinton's inaugural parade route. Let's give them a listen.
We're just about halfway through tonight's San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
Would you believe it? And coming up the street, a whole barnyard full of baby chicks. Stay with us.
On Southwest Airlines, friends fly free for business, too. For example, if Dunn buys a ticket, Bradstreet flies free. Buy one round-trip ticket at Southwest Airlines' regular low, unrestricted fare, and your friend flies with you, free. So if Bausch buys a ticket, Lam flies free. Or if Ben buys a ticket, Jerry flies free. Friends fly free for business. Only on Southwest Airlines, just plain smart.
This is the Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme Special Edition. It's got a V6, 4-speed automatic, air, cruise control, and other neat stuff. It's also $4,000 less than a Honda Accord, $4,100 less than a Toyota Camry, and more than $5,000 less than that Nissan Maxima. The Cutlass Supreme Special Edition. It's your choice.
If you and your checking account could use a change of scene, come on over to Wells Fargo Bank. Enjoy longer hours, 5-minute max teller service, 24-hour person-to-person phone service, and a Wells Fargo Stagecoach check that's a change of scene all by itself. Move all your accounts to Wells Fargo today. The change of scene will do you good. Wells Fargo Bank, a better brand of service.
Carjacking, the crime that makes you feel like an easy target. What can you do to protect yourself from being the next victim? Channel 2's consumer editor Tom Vakar brings you some amazing new devices that could stop carjackers dead in their tracks and keep you from having to choose between your car or your life. Monday on the original 10 o'clock news, only on Channel 2. Ever looked down the business end of a Nike missile? Here's your chance. Gary Kauf in top secret territory, right in our own backyard. Monday on Mornings on 2. The San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade continues and is sponsored in part by Oldsmobile, the power of intelligent engineering.
And here's a colorful group of guys. They're named Fook, Luke, and Cao.
The puppets represent three things many Chinese people seek in life. Fook represents prosperity, and he's dressed in red clothing. And Luke has a black beard and is wearing a long, flowing robe. He stands for position or status in life. And Cao, the old man with the white beard, represents longevity.
I understand a lot of Chinese families have statues or pictures of these figures in their homes.
That's true, including the firecrackers. They're very popular.
And Southwest Airlines presents the Yugong Gung Fu Sport Association with 12 lion dance teams. And this award-winning dance group and martial arts group are wearing their trademark yellow Gung Fu uniforms.
And the boy with the pink face right there, he teases the dragon. Or the lion, for that matter.
Well, that could be a little dangerous, couldn't
it,
teasing
a
lion? He's a very brave boy with a pink face.
This one looks like a little girl, though. Now, I would think it'd be a lot of fun to be the lion dancer in front, but the guy in back has a tough job holding up the back of that lion.
You know, these lion dancers are very, very skilled acrobats as well, as they, there's one person in the head of the lion, one person in the tail. The person in the head has to be agile enough to jump on the tail's shoulders and perform all sorts of acrobatic feats. Personally, I think they're kind of cute.
Kind of cute as pets. This beat is so infectious. I mean, it is just lighting up the streets. I love this time of year.
I must take a lot of practice to be able to work in synchronization the way they do.
And coming into view of the lion dancer with a 180-foot-long dragon. There are 25 people carrying the dragon in the parade tonight, and they're doing a magnificent job of guiding this creature through the city streets of San Francisco.
Giving you a double dose here. We're giving you lion and dragon dancers.
That's right.
Two
for the price of one.
Certainly one of the more colorful groups as well, as you can see the multicolored dragons and the lions and all of the dancers in their yellow outfits. As they serpentine up the street.
There he is, following his precious pearl.
I wonder if that's where putting the carrot in front of the donkey comes from, putting the pearl in front of the dragon.
Maybe the Asian twist.
Well, so much of our
story.
Culture comes from the Asian people who came here in the early days of our nation.
The Chinese New Year Parade has been a tradition for over 135 years.
Here in San Francisco,
absolutely. Yeah.
That's
Can you imagine?
I was at the first parade, and I remember it well. As a matter of fact, I think this was the same dragon that was in the first parade back 135 years ago.
It's an antique.
Well, the Chinese community is such a part of this city's history. And all you have to do is take them. Shirley Fontorius does walking tours through Chinatown. And it's a wonderful educational experience because you learn so much about the heritage and the effect the Chinese community has had on San Francisco. That's one long dragon.
And now a whole clutch of chicks honoring the Year of the Rooster. These kids are from the Sutro School in San Francisco. Their theme is Foul Ball and Go Giants Go. A salute to the San Francisco Giants baseball team.
I think everybody's happy they're staying here right now. I tell you, this was a year we almost lost the Giants in San Francisco, but thanks to some very smart businessmen, we've managed to keep them here.
And that chicken coop is being carried by parents and teachers from Sutro School, and it's decorated with art projects that the kids did in class about Chinese New Year.
Some of those uniforms you're seeing there, baseball uniforms, were donated by the San Francisco Giants.
There's about 30 kids inside the coop, and they're dressed as roosters and some in the baseball regalia that Cynthia mentioned.
And singing the old song, take me out to ball game. Sing with me, Steve.
No. No, we don't want me to sing. We definitely don't want me to sing. And striding up the parade path, the Irvine High School Marching Vaqueros Band from Irvine, California, presented by Southwest Airlines.
The 130 musicians and flag carriers in the Marching Vaqueros are no strangers to this Chinese New Year parade. They've been awarded prizes for their performance here three times.
And this marks their seventh appearance in the San Francisco Chinese New Year parade. Bunch of characters that really like to party. They're known as the Eight Immortals in Chinese folklore.
And they're wonderful characters. The group represents people from all walks of life, rich, poor, important, common, and they were ordinary people before becoming blessed or cursed with the gift of immortality. The Eight Immortals have many magical powers, and they can help others to achieve the dream of eternal youth.
And they're certainly having a good time tonight celebrating the new year.
Oh, this is a cuddly pair. Ooh. It's a bunch of a mother and a baby panda on the Southwest Airlines float, and their theme tonight is Friends Fly Free.
Now, Cynthia, of course, the panda is considered to be a national treasure in China. It's the nation's mascot and easily recognizable the whole world over as a symbol of China's wonderful natural resources.
The Chinese revere the panda. I think because it's in part the strong bond between the mother panda and their babies. And of course, family ties are a very important part of the Chinese culture. In fact, during Chinese New Year celebrations, one of the most important things you can do is to visit relatives and wish them health and happiness in the year to come.
And I see that you have your whole family here with you today.
Right.
They're sitting in the grandstands
enjoying the parade.
Your mom and dad, your grandma.
That's right.
Yes, they're all here today.
The whole clutch.
The whole clutch of cows are here.
That's right. And the scouts are out in force tonight. This time it's the drum and bugle corps from Boy Scout Troop 12 right here in San Francisco. Troop 12 is the second oldest Boy Scout troop in the country, and they were founded way back in 1915.
And they're great performers. In fact, they received one of the highest honors the Boy Scouts can bestow. They were chosen to represent the Scouts at the 500th anniversary of the Discovery of America celebration in Washington, D.C. last year. And let's listen to them.
Coming up on our coverage of the 1993 San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade, a fire-breathing dragon stalks the streets of San Francisco.
And we'll be visited by a Chinese goddess. Stay with us.
What's fun in California?
A 1993 Toyota 4x4. Nothing else comes close.
You see someone pour tea at your next Chinese dinner, and you see the other diner respond by tapping the table. It's a silent Chinese gesture of thank you.
How long has it been since you had something good? I mean, something delicious, something dynamite. Well, Taco Bell has the food I like. So good, so good, so good, so good.
Taco Bell is bringing excitement back to breakfast.
So good.
Because only Taco Bell gives you so many morning favorites for just 59 cents.
So good. Well, run for the border, yes, understood. Gotta be Taco Bell, because I know, oh, well, what's good.
Wake up to breakfast at the border.
I can't wait until tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Tomorrow.
Of all the overnight services, only one delivers on Sundays. Even Sunday, February 14th, express mail from the Postal Service.
It's so beautiful, Tim.
Tom.
Tom.
We deliver for you.
It's the year of the rooster and the San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
And here's a dramatic shot we'll see many more times tonight. It's a bird's eye view of the parade, and we want to thank the Grand Hyatt Hotel on Union Square for that picture. They let us put one of our cameras on the 14th floor of their building. And there now. Hi, fellas. They're probably ordering room service as we speak. These scary-looking characters walking by now, the legendary 7th and 8th floors, and seeing them is supposed to bring good luck.
See, there's a reason why they're disfigured. The shorter, bloated character with a black face is the 8th Lord. Is the 7th Lord. The two were lifelong friends, and legend has it that the two lords were caught in a terrible storm. The 8th Lord drowned, and his best friend, the 7th Lord, felt so guilty that he hung himself.
But because of their loyalty, they were kept together through eternity as protectors of the local gods of each city.
And each city has its own local gods, so in San Francisco, since Mayor Jordan is our highest local authority, the 7th and 8th Lords would protect him.
Kind of an ominous-looking characters, aren't they?
And here comes the imperial procession for the goddess Matsu. Guards being members of the Matsu Temple here in San Francisco. One guard is blue-faced, here for 1,000 miles, and the red-faced guard can see for 1,000 miles.
Well, with that kind of talent, I bet the Secret Service wishes it could hire them.
Now, the statue of the goddess Matsu, she's a protector of travelers at sea, and her title is Queen of Heaven. She's in a sedan chair.
And we're told the goddess is busy blessing people along the parade route to drive away evil spirits. The San Francisco Matsu Temple, in 1986, everything in the parade is made from materials sent from the temple in Taiwan. And everything you're seeing in the parade tonight is either hand-carved or hand-sewn.
take a look at this magnificent and scary creature. It's a Pacific Bell Smart Yellow Pages dragon.
And the huge dragon is perched on his float, breathing smoke as he scowls his way down our foggy.
Steve, you're beginning to sound like a cheap detective novel.
Seriously, Cynthia, this is one of the largest floats in the parade. The dragon is 48 feet long, and it's the only float built out of real flowers.
Oh.
There are straw flowers on the dragon's legs, Chinese lantern flowers on the jaw, and moss and palm fiber on the base. And that pagoda is made out of real bamboo.
And for the folks at home, they are distributing incense. That is kind of permeating our air right now.
And for the folks here, it's a welcome blessing to smell the incense as opposed to the gunpowder from the fireworks in the previous look.
Now helping usher in the Year of the Rooster, it's the Luther Burbank Middle School Band. Luther Burbank Middle School is the only public school in San Francisco that still has its own marching band.
And the school is named after a famed horticulturist, Luther Burbank, who lived and worked in Santa Rosa, creating new fruits, vegetables, and flowers. The 60-piece group is under the direction of SBA Lewis this evening.
And if you thought some of the dragons we've seen tonight were scary, get a load of this guy. It's a Chinese Ghostbuster, Zheng Kuei. He's presented by the California Lottery. He catches the fiercest demons with his bare hands, and then he feeds them to his pet tigers.
And joining the demon chaser on the float are members of the Piedmont Ancient American. This is the very first time this figure has been seen in a parade anywhere in the United States.
He's thought to be an exorcist, banishing evil spirits, demons, and devils. Zheng Kuei is also associated with bats, and the Chinese word for bats is something that sounds the same as the Chinese word for prosperity. We have planes, boats, and cable cars here in the years of the Rooster Parade, and now a stagecoach. It's a replica of the Western Stagecoach sponsored by Wells Fargo.
And the stagecoach is traveling in the land of the Golden Mountain, which is what Chinese people used to call the United States. It's a reminder of the days when Chinese laborers came to work in California's gold mines and stayed to build an enduring presence and community. Still to come, a thrilling exhibition of grace, speed, and coordination as a Kung Fu master shows us how to use the Shaolin, that's the double broadsword.
Stay with us, more of the 1993 Chinese New Year Parade.
Good evening, I'm Brian Bandmiller. Tonight at 10:30 on The Money.
There he is, there he is.
Should you worry about being murdered at work? A growing concern over disgruntled employees who shoot to kill. This man has a license to steal. We'll spend the night with one of the best repo men in the country. And does this look painful? The controversy over thousands of people now seeking alternative medical treatments. Those stories, plus our American success story, a local man making millions with his hobby. Tonight at 10:30 on The Money. We'll see you then.
If you and your checking account could use a change of scene, come on over to Wells Fargo Bank. Enjoy longer hours, 5-minute max teller service, 24-hour person-to-person phone service, and a Wells Fargo stagecoach check that's a change of scene all by itself. Move all your accounts to Wells Fargo today. The change of scene will do you good. Wells Fargo Bank, a better brand of service.
The reviews are in, and this new Toyota is a winner. Automobile Magazine calls it a global success. Motor Trend calls it a car with definite family influences from Camry and Lexus. Detroit Free Press calls it the benchmark. We call it Corolla. Presenting the all-new Toyota Corolla. Discover why, after 25 years, it's still impressing all the right people.
The San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade continues and is sponsored in part by Wells Fargo Bank. Enjoy a better brand of service. Move all of your accounts to Wells Fargo today.
And welcome back. And now passing through the parade review area, San Francisco Jingmo Athletic Association. Jingmo is a kung fu group that practices the traditional northern Shaolin style of kung fu. Now, the highlight of this unit is a demonstration of the northern Shaolin double broadswords, and the martial arts master will spend part of his routine performing a series of complicated moves while on the ground and while he's being circled by a dragon that's 100 feet long. We don't see the dragon yet, but there is the martial arts master with the double broadswords.
Now, Kung Fu was originally developed as a fighting art in China, and it was practiced in secret because oppressed people were not allowed to know martial arts, and they didn't want their enemies to know how skilled they were in defending themselves. And they would then use common tools around the village to fight with, such as sectional staffs and things like that. And for many years, Kung Fu was taught within families alone in secret societies. Today, the Kung Fu art is open to everybody. But of course, the Jingmo organization is dedicated to open community training, both in China and around the world.
Now, Jingmo started in China in 1909, and the San Francisco Jingmo group began in the 1960s. And here come the lions we told you about. And Jingmo practices the northern style of kung fu with lots of kicks, and the southern style has lots of hand and arm movements. And either one, shows an incredible level of physical coordination.
This is a community-built float from the Asian American Donors Program. It's a 10-foot-tall Japanese origami crane. The Asian American Donors Program is a community group dedicated to finding bone marrow donors for people with cancer.
And the organization works with Chinese American, Japanese American, Korean American, Filipino American, and other Asian communities throughout Northern California to find donors for those in need. And coming up, the lion dances from the West Portal Chinese Immersion Program. They're being sponsored by Oldsmobile this evening. West Portal is a San Francisco public school that teaches the Cantonese dialect of the Chinese language.
There are 40 dancers in this group and 10 young women carrying the banners.
Our big hit with the fans here. And following the lion dancers is a beautiful float illustrating a romantic Chinese legend known as The Lady in the Moon.
There's one version of the story. Once upon a time, 10 sun gods circled the earth and caused droughts and other nasty things to happen to our world. So the King of Heaven sent a hunter and his wife to shoot down all but one of the sun gods. The King of Heaven was so pleased with the hunter's success, he gave the pair a magic pill that would make them immortal. The two were supposed to share the pill, but of course the hunter's wife accidentally swallowed it by herself. The King of Heaven banished her to the moon, and each year the August Moon Festival celebrates the one night that her husband can join her in her celestial domain.
Oh, what a sweet story.
Yeah.
Nice.
And a beautiful float.
Absolutely beautiful float. And our next parade entrant is the Westboro Middle School Marching Band. There are 71 students in this energetic unit. They're in the 6th, 7th, and 8th grades. The band and its majorettes, rifle platoon, and flag bearers travel throughout North America, entertaining audiences from California to Canada, and they've played at both Disneyland and Disney World. That must be quite a kick for students that young. They're in the 6th, 7th, and 8th grades to be able to travel all through California, Canada, Disneyland, Disney World to perform for people. Saxophone's almost as big as her.
You know, Steve, I had a hard enough time just playing the clarinet when I was in high school, let alone march with it.
You played the clarinet?
And not very well, I might add. Well, these are members of the Chung Nai Drama Club with a beautiful rooster garden on their float.
There are a dozen dancers between the ages of 5 and 8 celebrating the plentiful harvest and the plentiful rain we've been receiving.
But luckily, not tonight. The Drama Club is very active in the community, training many young people in the Chinese performing arts. And the Chinese characters on that pagoda translate to wishing you peace as you come and go.
And the action continues here at the 1993 San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade. Coming up, a visit from someone everyone loves, especially around tax time.
And don't forget, Bart and Homer Simpson will be flying right by.
As well as the best disguised undercover cops in the country when we return.
I drove it for 8 years.
Your Toyota dealer invites you to see the all-new Corolla.
I never got so much out of a car.
And discover a special lease program that makes getting a new Corolla easier than ever.
But I've gone on to bigger and better things. Just got the new one.
For as little as $179 a month with no money down, you get more room, more comfort, and more safety features. A great car becomes a great deal. Discover the new Corolla lease program at your Toyota dealer and rediscover value.
Miller Genuine Draft. It's cold filtered. That's how we keep our commitment to everyone who knows that draft beer is real beer. Pure beer. The best beer. It's why so many people can enjoy a beer whose taste hasn't been changed by heat pasteurization. And why so many people are making a change of their own. To the genuine, genuine draft. Get out of the old. Get into the cold.
At New Year's, little red money envelopes are given by each married person to each unmarried person. It's a sign of prosperity to start the new year.
Finding a credit card you can expect more from is a simple process of elimination.
First, blow up all the cards with the highest rates. Then the ones that don't offer fixed or variable rate options, worldwide acceptance, and 24-hour customer service. And what about price assurance? Satisfaction guaranteed, purchase protection, and extended warranties at no extra charge. So, what's left?
Chemical Bank MasterCard. If you have one, use it.
If not, call 1-800-342-9900 to apply.
Ciao, molto bene. Mama Burger King will be so happy.
I love this place.
Yes. Take it from me, Danny Paisan. Have you tried the new Italian sausage sandwich here? It's Italian sausage flame broiled. It comes with either mozzarella or marinara sauce or peppers and onions. This is for you. You try it. This is the Italian experience. I'm not saying this sandwich is great, but I saw Mona Lisa smiling. It's like a slice of Italy. It's your way, right away.
I love this place.
The San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade continues with your hosts, Steve McPartland and Cynthia Gao.
Well, you can't miss the message of this next float. Don't smoke. It's the entry from the Chinese Community Smoke-Free Project sponsored by the Chinese Community Health Plan and the Chinese Community Health Care Association.
And Steve, that dragon looks like it has a 2-pack-a-day habit. And I'm sure those kids that were on the float before, but they had previously marched down because this float had broken down, I'm sure they were trying to get him to quit.
And now here's a team made up of San Francisco's finest, the police department's lion dancing troupe. There are about 20 officers involved this year dressed up in traditional gung-fu uniforms.
They're very popular. They took first place for line dancing in both the 1991 and 92 Chinese New Year parade.
And San Francisco's police force is the only one in the country with a lion dance team.
Now, the lion right now might be crossing a bench, the symbolic crossing of a bridge, and demonstrates the agility of this lion. You might be seeing that coming up. And there he is, jumping up on that bench. Now, people thought back in ancient China that lion dancing would ward off evil spirits. But over the years, the superstition has worn off, and lion dancing is performed to bring joy, happiness, and of course, good luck.
The lion is unfurling a banner in his mouth now. There he goes. As I mentioned before, these are quite agile performers to do the lion dancing.
These giant puppets are the Monkey King and his three traveling companions, the monk, the priest, and the pig, or commonly known as Pigby. All four are some of the most beloved characters in Chinese literature. They're from the famous fairy tale, The Monkey King.
And together they journey west to India to find the Buddhist scriptures and bring them back to China. Along the way, there are some interesting adventures.
Which makes for a more than 100 chapter story. Then the Monkey King is the leader. He's very streetwise and worldly, and he's supposed to bring good luck and prosperity.
And these figures are from a popular Chinese tale called The Romance of the Three Kingdoms. The four men were generals and sworn brothers.
Their names are Lao, Guan, Cheng, and Chu.
And they represent loyalty and righteousness. And you might notice that one of the figures is wearing a costume that's half military and half civilian. He's Brother Quan and is also the god of literature and war.
This community float was built by the Chinese-American International School in San Francisco, the only school in the country that teaches all of its classes in both Mandarin and English. And Steve, more people speak Mandarin than any other language in the world.
I didn't know that. That's amazing. The float features a replica of an ornate marble boat found in the famous Imperial Summer Palace in Beijing. In Chinese mythology, the ship represents smooth sailing, and the Chinese-American International School thinks that its goal of achieving bilingual education will provide a brighter, more harmonious future for its graduates.
And now it's time to send in the clowns, the Islam Shrine Clowns from San Jose.
Oh, and they're a fun group entertaining thousands of people along the parade route with jokes and balloon tricks. And they do a lot of charity performances throughout the year at hospitals and schools. He looks like he could use to lose a few pounds, huh?
All right, and right behind the clowns, the San Francisco Shriners Islam Temple Arabians Oriental Band.
Oh boy, just look at those great costumes. The musicians are playing a Chinese brass instrument called the dida. It's also known as a musette.
And they play all over the U.S. every year.
Hey, everybody's favorite way to spend Thursday night is Bart and Homer from the hit TV show The Simpsons.
And I'm a little worried about Homer, Steve. With all that great food served during Chinese New Year, his pot belly might get out of control.
It's not pot belly we're worried about there. At least Bart is getting a workout. I hope he hasn't injured anyone along the parade route. You never know what he's going
to
do.
Yeah, we'll have to keep an eye on both of them. And remember, you can see The Simpsons Thursday nights at 8 right here on Channel 2.
Certainly
can. There he goes. Our next group comes all the way from Minden, Navajo. It's Navajo, Nevada, the Douglas High School Fighting Tiger Band.
And as you might imagine from the name, the Fighting Tigers are a very competitive band. They started with just 12 musicians 6 years ago and now have 60 performers and a string of first place victories at band competitions throughout Nevada and California.
Everyone can relate to. It's the California State Lottery's tribute to the Chinese god of wealth. He's called Zai Zhen Ye, and his presence here at the beginning of the Year of the Rooster is sure to bring a good luck and prosperity to us all.
Well, Cynthia, the latest California lottery game is called Keno, right? Well, historians tell us the Chinese were playing this game 3,000 years ago, and they used to use doves and carrier pigeons to get the results out to the players.
After all the lion dancing beasts we see tonight, we'll get a chance to see some beauty of this reigning Chinatown, USA, when we return.
With more of the 1993 San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
How does the news here at home and around the world affect your career, your lifestyle, your wallet?
I'm Brian Bandmiller. This week, if this man breaks into your car, don't call the cops because he's licensed to steal.
Put the bag down, put the bag down. People come out and shoot at us. They try to kill us.
No badge, no gun, but a lot of guts.
I get scared on everyone just like it was my first time.
Meet the Repo Man on the next edition of On the Money.
Tonight at 10:30 on Channel 2.
This is the Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme Special Edition. It's got a V6, 4-speed automatic, air, cruise control, and other neat stuff. It's also $4,000 less than a Honda Accord, $4,100 less than a Toyota Camry, and more than $5,000 less than that Nissan Maxima. The Cutlass Supreme Special Edition. It's your choice.
MCI's Friends Around the World has been the lowest priced international call you can make to any one number to over 200 places around the world. Now MCI announces an extra 20% savings to two numbers. They'll be the lowest priced international calls you can make. Call MCI. Over the years, using us to call outside the country could save you hundreds upon hundreds of dollars.
Bell is bringing excitement back to breakfast.
So good.
Because only Taco Bell gives you so many morning favorites for just 59 cents.
So good.
Well, run for the border, yes, understood. Gotta be Taco Bell, because I know oh, well what's good.
Wake up to breakfast at the border.
San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade continues and is sponsored in part by Taco Bell. Visit participating Taco Bell restaurants for breakfast and try one of their five breakfast burritos.
Well, this group of martial artists are from Mr. Louis' Gung Fu Studio in San Francisco. They're running through their Gung Fu moves, and it's just amazing how much energy these folks pour into performing.
These lion dancers are very active during the year, performing at special celebrations like weddings and birthdays and charity events. Now, it's significant that many lions have ribbons on their heads. According to Chinese folklore, one of the gods cut off the lion's head, and the goddess of mercy came to the rescue, helping the lion tie it back on with a ribbon.
How about that? I wonder if that's how the custom of wearing a necktie came. Probably not.
And your head will fall off if you take it off?
That's a real stretch, isn't it?
And with Heartbreak Hotel ushering in the California Central Valley, the Delano High School Golden Tiger Band.
Hey, they're looking great tonight in those West Point style uniforms that they've placed in the top three positions of every competition they've been in since 1984.
Washington, D.C. later this year by the National Park Service.
Let's listen.
Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.
Steve, I had no idea you could dance like that.
Well, I could sing like that. And that was the Delano High School Golden Tiger Band playing Heartbreak Hotel.
And now for something completely different, a group that would rather ride than walk.
And this stylish antique bus belongs to a group that really knows how to get around, the Chinese Americans at Muni, the San Francisco bus and tram line.
They're riding in a historic bus built way back in 1938. It remains in service, carrying passengers up and down San Francisco's Telegraph Hill until being retired from active service in the 1970s.
That's a cool-looking old bus, huh?
That's right. Cruising down the avenue.
1939 is the year on the placard in front of it. Well, this is the first for the Chinese New Year Parade, a helium balloon dragon. It's 50 feet long and is sponsored by New York Life. And there are 20 members of the Chinese Americans at Muni guiding this giant creature down the streets.
Carrying this is harder than it looks,
Steve. I would think so.
Now, this dragon rides up about 15 feet up in the air, and it's a good thing a lot of these Muni folks are carrying it because they've got a duck underneath some power lines the electrical streetcars used to get around San Francisco.
Yeah, I think that's why they're holding him down so close to the ground there, to make sure they do get under those lines.
Look at the detail on that dragon. He kind of looks friendly, like he's got a smile on his face.
I always worried about that, you know. Well, I mean, there's
a friendly dragon.
There's 20 guys carrying that, but if 10 guys decided to let go, what would happen to the other 10 guys? They'd float away.
From north of the California border, our next group is from Phoenix, Oregon, the Phoenix High School Pirate Band.
Let's straighten this out right from the start. Phoenix is a small town just a few miles southeast of Medford, Oregon. There are 90 talented musicians and flair carriers in this group, and they had a chance to travel to Hawaii last year to play in the King Kamehameha Parade in Honolulu. Miss Chinatown USA, Melissa Wu. Melissa won last year's competition and spent the year representing the Asian American community. She's 20 years old and a sophomore at San Francisco State University, where she's majoring in marketing. Cynthia, you were Miss Channeltown USA in 1984. What was that like for you?
Well, Steve, of course, I was 10 years old then,
yes,
and one of the youngest Miss Chinatowns ever. Very mature. Oh, it was a lot of fun. It was great.
Right. Okay. Well, coming up, we'll greet the new Miss Chinatown USA, Melissa Yeh.
And we'll have a chance to check out the antics of a band that's so outrageous, it's been banned in several U.S. cities. Stay with us.
Volvo just figured out how to lower the defense budget without threatening national security. Call for the dealer nearest you. While the new administration may offer Americans a new lease on life, we can definitely offer you a new lease on a Volvo. Call for the dealer nearest you.
In Northern England, the locals play a game called ferret legging. The winner is the man who remains standing longest with two untamed ferrets in his trousers.
Aren't you glad you live in California? Here we just rather play Keno, the new lottery game with a top prize of $250,000 cash, which, as you might imagine, is lots better than a ferret in your trousers. Keno, what's fun in California?
It's no accident that the land of opportunity is open 24 hours a day. The good life is available, but they don't hand it out on the planet. It's no accident either that Bank of America has longer branch hours, a 24-hour customer service line, and a versatile ATM everywhere you turn around. Hard as America works, you could use a little easy. Banking on America. Bank of America.
Anyone can see.
Excuse me.
Hey.
She's capable.
Who the hell's that?
Hey, you want to call your husband, tell him you're working late?
No.
Now, Peter Derns is about to learn.
In case you haven't noticed, we're running out of executives around here.
What she's capable of. The Temp.
Morning.
Rated R. Starts Friday, February 12th at theaters everywhere.
It's the year of the rooster and the San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
Rising sun. That's the theme of the Zhongnai dance troupe float. As the rooster crows to announce daybreak, that rising sun in the center of the float will pop up 15 feet. You can see it rising now. That magnificent Peking lion and the lion tamer will get the ride of their lives, I guess. They're going up with the sun.
And with the sun rises at dawn, it's the rooster's crow that welcomes the birth of a new day and of this new year.
What a great way to celebrate.
Now, there are 12 ladies sitting on the back of there, the float, and they're being awakened by the rooster's crow.
And, of course, the lion tamer is teasing the lion with the pearl, the red ball, rather. There are the 12 girls in the back of the float. And now the sun is setting on the float.
On to...
It must be time for the 12 girls to go back to sleep.
And now the St. Mary's School Chinese Drum and Bell Corps, sponsored by Home Savings of America.
Now this group has quite a history, Cynthia. They formed 53 years ago and are the oldest Chinese drum and bell corps in the United States.
And they're all girls wearing beautiful ceremonial embroidered Chinese costumes.
And the group performed at the Kennedy Presidential Inaugural in 1961. And they've played in cities across America and they've played overseas. They're often called the ambassadors of San Francisco's Chinese community.
And now the St. Mary's School Chinese grill team.
And they have great precision maneuvers. They look like they're having a great time tonight.
It's considered quite an honor to be chosen to participate in this group. And all the girls have maintained high academic standards in order to join the drill team.
And of course, that's our cameraman in the middle of
He doesn't look like a...
Yeah, he's not a member of the drill team.
Drum corps,
I
want
to point that out to everybody, just in case they were wondering about the guy with a different uniform. He's not part of the St. Mary's drill team at all. No, he's not. Very colorful and beautiful costumes. Chinese girl drill team.
It's Melissa Yeh, the new Miss Chinatown USA of 1993. She's accompanied by her quarter princesses, and the royal float is sponsored by Harrah's.
And she looks very comfortable on top of that red temple.
Melissa is 19 years old and is originally from the town of Spring, Texas. She's a sophomore at Rice University, majoring in music, and her specialty is the violin. In fact, her career goal is to be a professional violinist in the symphony orchestra.
Oh, wonderful.
And there she is. She'll spend the next year representing San Francisco's Chinatown at civic and cultural events across the globe. Hello, Melissa.
Now, we weren't kidding. Before 1984, you were Miss Chinatown USA. They keep you very busy in doing that, don't they?
Very much so. We went to Asia a couple times and very busy here in Chinatown, spreading goodwill. And
and you can see
having a good time.
As every beauty queen has her court.
That's right, and I'm still friends with them. They're a terrific bunch of gals. These women look like a lot of fun. And they're from all over the Chinatowns, all over the United States. It's amazing.
And that is Melissa Yeh, the new Miss Chinatown USA for 1994. Well, we've got a whole family of lions with us now. More than 40 performers are here from the Duk Fei Wang Martial Arts Center in San Francisco, and they're being presented by Miller Genuine Draft.
Grandmaster Duk Fei Wang started the school in 1968. He teaches a Shaolin martial arts system that's over 150 years old.
Boy, he's got some fantastic students, because it looks pretty tough having someone stand on his shoulders and stay balanced as these lion dancers do all the time.
It's amazing. You know, they've got participants in this parade from ages 4 to 60 years old.
Here they go. See there. They're performing the...
Notice our cameraman now is far away from you. Oh, there he goes, the zoom lens.
They're performing with the bamboo stick now. Shaolin Kung Fu. Once again, we should remind everybody the difference between the lions and the dragons. Lion dancers have usually two performers, and the dragons have many, many performers, up to 20, maybe more.
Watch out, move!
What was he saying? Watch out, watch out? And here are some of the younger lion dancers. As we said, this troupe has lion dancers from the ages of 4 to 60 years old.
Now, I wonder if you're older, do you get the privilege of being on top or on bottom?
Well,
that's always a question.
Which is the easiest there?
I don't know.
Let's not discuss that. It's really funny. If you just look at the lion's head, it really looks live.
It has a life of its own, exactly.
And the way through the movement of the dancer, the jaw moves and the manipulation of the eyes. Uh-oh. Well, what can we say about this next group? Only in California, my friends, the Balloon Platoon.
The Balloon Platoon is from the city of Pleasanton and are actually a lot more normal.
They're
led by Commodore Dick Howard. And the people inside these baggy sailor suits are accountants, airline pilots, and business managers. But of course, part-time.
I guess they get a little chance to blow up a little steam during this parade.
I certainly hope so. This imprecision drill team is a favorite at events around the Bay Area. Tonight, in honor of the Year of the Rooster, they're performing a maneuver called the Shake and Bake.
I could just see one of these accounts going to an IRS audit dressed like this, couldn't you? Probably. And that's a great shot.
Coming through.
Talk about bringing out the rear. I'll tell you, ladies and gentlemen. The Balloon Platoon from Palo Alto, California. It's the Leland Stanford Junior University Marching Band, sponsored by Miller Genuine Draft.
Now, they have quite a naughty reputation, Steve. In fact, they're one of the few bands in the country that have been banned from playing in Eugene, Oregon, and South Bend, Indiana.
Well, Cynthia, this is a group of very popular young people. Let's listen to them. They're a lot of fun. The grand finale of the 1993 San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
60,000 firecrackers will herald the arrival of Gum Lung, the giant golden dragon of Chinatown.
And you'll get to see a lion dancing 18 feet in the air. Stay with us. Wow.
I work hard for my money.
It goes way too fast.
So I look for good deals. Things that'll last.
We're buying a Toyota.
It's a great car for the family. Now comes the hard part. Corolla,
Tercel,
or Camry. They're the family cars by Toyota.
T-O-Y-O-T-A.
Get a great deal on a Corolla, Tercel, or Camry now at your Northern California Toyota dealer.
On Southwest Airlines, friends fly free for business, too. For example, if Dunn buys a ticket, Bradstreet flies free. Buy one round-trip ticket at Southwest Airlines' regular low, unrestricted fare, and your friend flies with you, free. So if Bausch buys a ticket, Lom flies free. Or if Ben buys a ticket, Jerry flies free. Friends fly free for business. Only on Southwest Airlines, just plain smart.
Cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft. For those who've discovered its smooth draft taste, the world
Since the Chronicle first hit the streets of San Francisco in 1865, we haven't missed a day. Whether the news was bad or whether the news was good, the Chronicle has delivered it now for 46,780 mornings, even when nature shook the city down. As a young new president takes office and Chinese New Year 4691 begins, we invite you to join in the grand old tradition and wake up to the Chronicle every morning.
The San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade is sponsored in part by Southwest Airlines. It's just plain smart. Cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft, your Northern California Toyota dealer, and the San Francisco Chronicle.
Now for the fantastic finish to tonight's parade. First, the Lion Dancers from San Francisco's White Crane Kung Fu Studio.
And what you can see now is a very dangerous ceremony. One of the lions climbs an 18-foot pole to show his bravery and strength. And then he dances on top of the pole and unfurls a banner and wishes everybody a happy and prosperous New Year.
Well, that certainly is a dangerous thing to do. He's a very brave young man. And a very skilled young man, I mean that. I'm sure he wouldn't do it, or he wouldn't be allowed to do it if it was as dangerous as it looks. And now what you're seeing now, the highlight of the grand finale, the 160-foot-long Golden Dragon, sponsored by Miller Genuine Draft.
This mighty dragon is named Gum Lung, and it takes three different shifts of 22 people to carry it along the parade route.
And there are, or will be, any moment now, 60,000 firecrackers popping off, and that will scare away just about all of the evil spirits of the new year.
Here they go.
Here they go.
And he's still on his pole. He held on.
He's still gone. He's up on the pole. The lion's on the pole, and the dragon is continuing through the parade route.
The dragon was made in Hong Kong, and it has a collapsible bamboo frame. It takes about a week to put it together, and of course, later on, it's stored after the ceremony, I'm sure, in a huge warehouse.
And as you can see, the finale's not over as the lights are dimming on the street in front of the reviewing stand. This dragon is lighting up. Gum Lung is lighting up and coiling himself up.
Children are often told a dragon is stored in the city's sewer system, and that's why you see steam coming up from the manholes.
You know, Gum Lung promised to bring rain in the new year, and I guess his appearance has worked lately, at least.
Oh, he's beautiful.
And there's
the
smoke coming out of his mouth. Fantastic spectacle.
Amazing. I love this time of year.
The people in the reviewing stand, the crowd here lined up to see this, are just absolutely enjoying this grand finale.
And tonight it really isn't too cold. I mean, compared to last year when it was cold and rainy and wet, there we go. And that wraps up this year's celebration for the Year of the Rooster.
On behalf of Cynthia Gao and myself, I'd like to thank you for joining us for the 1993 San Francisco Chronicle Chinese New Year Parade.
And be sure to tune in next year when we celebrate the Chinese New Year of 4692, the year of the dog.
And you'll be with us, right?
That's it.
Okay, one, two, three. Good
day, Fatcha. Bye.
That is San Francisco.
Dakota Club Cab takes on all comers. With an available 230 horsepower Magnum V8, the new Ford Ranger doesn't offer a V8 engine. The new Toyota T100 doesn't either. Plus, Dakota has available four-wheel anti-lock brakes. This competition doesn't. And right now, you can get Dakota with up to $3,222 in total savings. So see your nearest Dodge dealer today, because the original true midsize pickup is still the greatest. The Dodge Dakota Club Cab.
Those who expect more from a credit card must not settle for less. First, eliminate cards charging the highest rates or not offering fixed or variable rate options. Demand worldwide acceptance, 24-hour customer service, and gold card benefits. And insist upon price assurance, purchase protection, extended warranties, and satisfaction guarantee. So what remains? The Grand Elite Visa Gold Card from Chemical Bank. If you possess one, do use it. If not, call 1-800-342-9900 to apply.
I definitely saved a few bucks at the Shane Company. My doctor told me about him. And he said...
They've got it all. Selection, quality, price. I heard about the Shane Company from my wife's friend, Nora. She got a heck of a...
The Shane Company had these great pearl earrings. Lee from the apartment across the hall recommended them. He said he bought some for his...
The salespeople really know this stuff, and they're just plain nice. My cousin told me about the Shane Company. He bought a ring.
The Shane Company. Trust your friend.
Okay, so you're the young, adventurous type. Get a legendary Jeep Wrangler at this low price. When you're ready...